Blepharitis is also known as bugs in your eyelashes, and doesn't sound so great, but I got a way for you to get rid of it for good. Hey, good optometry. I'm Dr. Michael Nelson, your YouTube eye doctor, and today I'm going to share with you what is blepharitis, what causes it, why it's bad for you, and the three ways that you can get rid of this for good. So technically speaking, blepharitis is an inflammation of the eyelids and the eyelashes, but I will often explain it to my patients as a chronic mild lid infection because we have normal bacteria that live on our skin. It's called the flora, and there's organisms, there's bugs and bacteria that live on our skin, and it's supposed to be there and it needs to be there. And you also have bugs and bacteria that live around your eyes and your eyelashes, and again, it's supposed to be there and need to be there. But in some individuals, there happens to be a little bit more than you need. And no fault of your own, not because you're dirty, but just because the environment is perfect. Could be maybe the pH is perfect, maybe the temperature is perfect, maybe they just like how you smell, I don't know. But for whatever reason, in some individuals, the bacteria that's living on your eyelashes and eyelids, it just goes crazy. So almost 50% of people have blepharitis. So that means if you're watching this video with someone else and they don't have blepharitis, that means you have blepharitis. And there's lots of different types of organisms that can contribute to blepharitis, but the most common one is bacteria. And there's a specific type of bacteria that loves to live on our eyelashes. It's called Staphylococcus aureus, and it's supposed to be there and it needs to be there. And when it goes a little bit crazy, you have more of them than you need, and they're also producing a lot more waste products than would actually be there. And those waste products are called exotoxins because they irritate the skin, and if they fall into your tears, they irritate the surface of your eye. Some people are very, very sensitive, hypersensitive to these exotoxins, and they get a significantly more amount of irritation and inflammation than other people, and those are the people that have blepharitis. And so although blepharitis really isn't going to cause any vision loss or permanent vision impairment, it's going to cause a whole ton of symptoms that are super, super annoying. So it can make your eyes burning. It might make them itchy, might make them stinging. It might cause your eyes to be red, not only your lids, but also the surface of your eyeball to be a little bit more red. It could cause crusting and sticking of your eyelids. It can cause a gritty, burning, almost foreign body, like something's in your eye all the time. It can cause you to have little flakes that look like little bits of dandruff in and amongst your lashes. It can cause you to be more sensitive to light, and it can cause you to blink more, and it can start to affect your lashes. It can cause your lashes to grow in funny directions, and it can cause your lashes to fall out, and it can cause you to have more frequent infections of your eyelids and the surface of your eye. But not only that, it can also cause dry eye disease because it can start to affect the glands in our lid called the meibomian glands and cause meibomian gland dysfunction, which is the most common form of dry eye disease. So eye doctors love to talk about details of blepharitis, and they'll often say there's anterior blepharitis and posterior blepharitis, but these are just academic terms, meaning the anterior affects the eyelashes and the posterior affects the glands, the meibomian glands at the back of the lid. But really, if you have one, you probably have both, and we're going to treat them both, and we're going to treat them the same way. Now, on a side note, blepharitis is also associated with conditions like rosacea and eczema, which also affect glands and the surface of our skin. So there are basically three ways that we're going to use to get rid of your blepharitis for good. Now, make sure you stay to the end of this video because I'm going to share with you some tips that you definitely don't want to do to treat your blepharitis. So first of all, we're going to talk about at-home methods that you can use to treat your blepharitis. So the first one is heating up your eyelids. So if we can heat up your lids, and more specifically, if we can heat up the glands, the meibomian glands in the back of your lid to around 41 degrees Celsius or 105 degrees Fahrenheit and keep it there for about 5 to 10 minutes, that can soften the oils in that gland, get them to start flowing better, and express out all the waste products and the inflammatory products that are building up in those glands, causing some of the blepharitis and the dry eye symptoms that you're having. So in order to do this, you can do some warming masks. So there's a few different types that you can get. All of these, you're going to heat them up in the microwave for a period of time. It's going to get nice and warm, and it's going to hold that heat for about 5 to 10 minutes. You can also get some of these gel packs. When you click them, they can get warmer, and then you can reset them. And there's also some electronic versions that you can plug into a USB port to get to warm the lid as well. And I'm going to put some affiliate links in the description down below, so if you want to pick any of these up to try, you can do so. Now, the next at-home thing that you need to be doing is cleaning around your eyelids. So we need to do some type of lid wipe to clean around our eyes. So all of us wash our body with soap. You wash your hair, you wash your body, but almost nobody washes their eyelids with soap because it stings and burns. And just splashing water or running water or spraying water on your eyes isn't going to get off the exotoxins or the bacteria. So you need some type of surfactant or solution to help clean off the exotoxin and the bacteria. All these lid wipes are available for you to use to clean and around your eyelids, and you use them once or twice a day on an ongoing basis to get rid of the exotoxins and the bacteria. Now, these are also available in a pump foam type of thing. So if you don't want to use the cloth, so if you don't want to use a towelette, you can just put it on your finger and then just scrub around your eyelashes and do that as well. And another at-home treatment that you can do is something called hypochlorous acid. And this is a spray. You just close your eyes and you just spray one spray on the surface of your eyelids. And if it falls into your eyes or your tears, it doesn't sting or irritate it. Sounds a little bit scary because it has the word acid in it, but this is safe to use in and around your eyes. What this will do is it will bring down the bacteria count in and around your eyelashes. Now, it's not going to get rid of the exotoxins, but it can help diminish the number of bacteria that you have on the surface of your eyelids, and you can do this once a day. So the second thing that we can do to treat your blepharitis for good is using some type of prescription product. So the first one that we might start to use when blepharitis really gets out of hand, it will be some type of antibiotic. Now, I typically will use an ointment for this because I want some on your eyelashes. And what you're going to typically do is clean your eyelids with some of the lid wipes first, and then you just put a little bit of antibiotic ointment on your finger. And you don't need very much. You don't need to cake it on. You just need a very, very minute amount of film, just wiping that on your lashes, and that will help bring down that bacteria count. Now, we will also sometimes use an antibiotic steroid medication because the antibiotic will get rid of the bacteria, and then the steroid will bring down the inflammation that's developing in and around the lid. Now, we need to be careful using steroids because long-term use of steroids in and around your eyes can increase the risk for glaucoma and cataracts, and we definitely want to avoid that. So we're typically only doing this to quiet down a really large flare-up of blepharitis. Now, there are also some oral antibiotics, and so oral antibiotics can sometimes be used to quiet down the inflammation as well as get rid of some of the bacteria count in and around the lashes. So these are all prescription products that we'll use in more serious cases of blepharitis. And the third option that you're going to use to get rid of your blepharitis for good is some type of in-office treatment that you're going to do at a doctor's office. And the three I'll mention here is there's one called BlephEx. And basically this is an instrument with a little brush that brushes and almost like a toothbrush that cleans around your lashes. And the ocular hygienist is going to use this in conjunction with some type of foam-like solution to clean and manually debride all the debris and help really get off some of that stubborn blepharitis that's building up. You can also have a treatment called radiofrequency or RF, which is a heat treatment to the lids to really get those glands flowing really, really well. And then there's another treatment called IPL or intense pulse light, which is really effective in reducing the bacteria count in and around the lashes. Now, I've got other videos on RF and IPL up here, and if you want to watch those. Now, a couple of things that you definitely don't want to do when you're treating your blepharitis. Number one, I mentioned about hot compresses and heating your lids. What you don't want to do is just use a washcloth because basically it cools off too quickly. You can heat it up under hot water, but then within about 10, 20 seconds, it's cold again. So you need something that holds the heat for a significant amount of time. The second thing you want to do when you're cleaning around the eyes, we used to recommend using baby shampoo because it doesn't sting your eyes so much. And some people are still recommending that, but they've done studies looking at baby shampoo and the preservatives and the soaps in baby shampoo, which technically don't sting your eyes as much, they can cause an inflammatory effect, and they've shown that they might not be as helpful as we thought. And you're better off using some of the specific eyelid wipes that are formulated for treating blepharitis and to be used around your eyes. And the last recommendation is there are over-the-counter antibiotics that you can pick up, but oftentimes they are not as effective as the prescription antibiotics that your doctor has prescribed. So I would avoid using any of the over-the-counter antibiotics to try to treat your blepharitis. Definitely see your eye doctor to try to treat them with those if you need them. Now, if you tried any or all of these options and it's not getting rid of your blepharitis, there's a possibility you might have a form of blepharitis that is not from bacteria, but from actually microscopic mites that are living on your eyelashes. And if you think you might have that, you really need to watch this video right here. And with that, have a great optometry day.